ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू डू टुडे एक्सपेरिमेंट ब्रिज वेव रेक्टिफायर. सो यू कैन सी द सर्किट डायग्राम वेर यू हैव ट्रांसफॉर्मर राइट एंड फोर डायोड्स कनेक्टेड लाइक दिस एंड अ रेजिस्टर विच इज 10 किलो ओम एंड CRO राइट. सो वील स्टार्ट विद द कनेक्शन. फर्स्ट वी विल कनेक्ट आवर डायोड्स. सो यू कैन जस्ट सी दिस इज वन डायोड वेर यू कैन सी दिस सिल्वर कलर इज नेगेटिव एंड ब्लैक कलर इज पॉजिटिव राइट. सो नाउ फर्स्ट कनेक्शन इज D1 विच इज पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव. सो मेक अ पॉइंट D1 पॉजिटिव वन साइड यू कनेक्ट एंड नेगेटिव वन साइड यू कनेक्ट राइट. सो दिस इज हाउ योर D1 इज बीन कनेक्टेड. द नेक्स्ट इन द सर्किट डायग्राम D2 वेर D1 इज नेगेटिव एंड D2 इज नेगेटिव हैज टू बी मेड वन कॉमन पॉइंट. सो यू कैन सी दैट इज मेड अ कॉमन पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट इज D3 दैट इज नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव ऑफ D2 हैज टू बी मेड अ कॉमन पॉइंट. सो नाउ दैट इज ऑल्सो बीन कनेक्टेड. नेक्स्ट द लास्ट वन इज D4 वेयर नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव ऑफ योर D1 हैज टू बी मेड कॉमन पॉइंट. फाइन. सो नाउ दिस इज बीन कनेक्टेड. योर D4 डायोड इज बीन connected. Next is, now the diode part has been done. The next we will do transformer, where transformer's positive, that is plus 12 volt, is connected D4 and D1 common. So D4 and D1 common is, that's it. So that point we are connecting. D4 and D1 is over here. Next is the zero, make one ground. Next, after now the connection for this AC supply, sorry, transformer and diode has been done. The last part is connecting the resistor. So now take this resistor, where it has been connected? It has been connected D4 and D2's common points. So that common point you select and another terminal you can take somewhere else. So at that terminal you have to connect the output. The last is, you can see this is the CRO. So where this channel is considered as input, this channel is considered as output. So this input channel, now this black color has to be connected to the ground and the red color has to be connected at D1 and D4, correct? So that point, common point, it has been connected. Output, now this channel is for your output, where black again it has to be connected to the common ground, and the red color has to be connected towards the this, that is another end of your resistor. Fine. So this is how your bridge wave rectifier connection is been done. So today we are going to do the first one, that is DC regulated power supply. So that is the continuation of the previous. So you can see till here we had done our connections and we had seen the output of the bridge wave rectifier. But this rectifier output, now we have to filter it, or we have to get a regulated output. Means if the plus 12 volt of transformer is given, you have to get the output plus 12 volt. That is nothing but you are getting a regulated output. So in order to get a regulated output, you are using two regulators, that is 7812 and 7912. So 7812 first pin, second pin and third pin, and 7912 that is here for 7812, first pin is your input, second pin is your ground, and third pin is your output. And for 7912, your first pin is ground, second pin is input, and third pin is output. So accordingly we are using these regulators, and we are using 0.1 microfarad, two capacitors over here, and 10 microfarad capacitors at this side. So this further, once you have got the bridge wave rectifier, you have to get a regulated output. So next we are going to connect our 10 microfarad one, that is between your D4 and D2, to some point. Okay, so that capacitor you have to connect to the first point of your 7812 regulator. Both are the common So it has to be connected. Next. So now we have connected our capacitor this and 78121. Next is the next connection. You can just see here. This has been connected over here. Okay. Next, the 10 microfarads negative has to be connected to the second as well as 7912's. You have connected from D4 to plus as well as this is going towards your 7812's first. So you can just see here this capacitor here it is connected to your D4, okay, and this one also is connected, all are in on a common point. And you can see that the second has been connected to the another end of your farad. So with the help of this wire, this is your second, it has been connected to the another end of your, you can see here, another end of the capacitor. Okay, next. Okay, so next connection is we have to connect this two and this one, correct? So you can see with the help of this, this regulator's one, that is 7912, is connected to the two of your 7812. This connection has been done. Next is this capacitor C2, two of your 792 has to be connected to your positive of your 10 microfarad. So this is your next 10 microfarad. So this second part is connected to this part, that is your capacitors. Next, this 192 is connected. Now this one has to be connected to the another end. So this one has to be connected to the another end. Fine. Next. Now we have to connect the three of your another capacitor end. So this is your next capacitor which you are connecting 1 microfarad. And for that you have to connect 7812's third terminal. So you are connecting 7812's third terminal to that capacitor's end. Fine. The next over here is, after this connection, the second of your 7812 has to be connected to the other end of your capacitor. So now we are connecting the second end of your 7812 to the other end of your capacitor. So here is the other end that has been connected. Next is 7912 third terminal has to be connected to the next capacitor. 7912 another capacitor you have to connect. Okay, so 7912's third terminal you have to connect, and here the third, that is the other end, and this has to be shorted or they have to be made common. So with the help of the wire we are connecting those two. Fine. So the next is the last part, is we have to ground this together wherever we have put this together, that you have to ground black color where you have made a common ground. And now this capacitors you have to see plus 12 volt, that is your output in your multimeter. So negative has to be connected to the ground, that is here, and positive has to be connected to this capacitor's end. You can see here also you have to get plus 12 volt, and if you see at this end you have to get minus 12 volt in your multimeter, right? Thank you, students.
This is output. We have given 12 volt and you have got 12 volt regulator.